given. Find the reactions offered by two surfaces of sphere weighing 1000 Newton as shown in figure. Diagram is provided. Here a sphere is there, resting between two planes. One is inclined at 40 degree, other is at 60 degree. We have to calculate the reactions offered by both the planes. So I'll write 60 degree plane, the contact point is P, and 40 degree plane, the contact point is Q. I'll write the data for this question first. One plane is inclined at 40 degree, other one is inclined at 60 degree. And a sphere is resting in between them. Next, the weight of the sphere is given as 1000 Newton. So I'll write the value of weight 1000 Newton. Here we have to calculate the reaction offered by both the supports. I've marked P as the contact point between sphere and 60 degree inclined plane, Q as the contact point between 40 degree inclined plane and the sphere. So if we see in this diagram, reaction at P, it will be perpendicular to the surface. I'll write this as R suffix P, reaction at P. Reaction at Q would be perpendicular to its surface. I'll write down it as R suffix Q. Now both the reactions, they are perpendicular to the surface. So first of all, we would be drawing the free body diagram for this sphere. I hope you all are getting this. And here the question is reaction at P and reaction at Q. I'll write the solution. Since FVD for given sphere is as follows. For FVD, first we will have to mark the weight, means I will be replacing the sphere with its weight. Weight is 1000 acting downwards. I have removed this sphere with its weight. Then RP, reaction at P, I will extend it up to the center. I will move it up to the center. This will be reaction at P. Then I'll draw a horizontal line. Similarly, I will be extending reaction at Q. Now I need to know the angle between each of them. Then only I can apply Lami's theorem. So here we know weight is inclined at 90 degree to the horizontal. Next, reaction at P, reaction in Q. We have to find their inclinations with respect to the horizontal line. So if RP, I can see it is perpendicular to the surface. This angle is 90. Here this is 60. So the remaining angle with the horizontal, that's 30. So angle of reaction at P with respect to horizontal is 30 degree. Similarly, here I have angle is 90 degree and this angle of inclined plane is 40. So reaction at Q is inclined at the horizontal at 90 minus 40, that is 50 Newton. 50 degree, the angle. Okay, it is not Newton. Now, here I have 50 and this is 30. So it is 50 plus 30. That gives me 80. So this remaining angle between RP and RQ, that is 100 degree. So as we can see in this problem, we have known the forces here and the angles between all of them. So I can easily apply Lami's theorem here. So I'll write down by Lami's theorem, I'll take W upon sine of angle between RP and RQ, that is 100 degree. Next, if I take RP, reaction at P, then I have to take angle between RQ and W, which is 50 plus 90. That gives me 140 degree. If I take RQ, angle between RP and W, that is 90 plus 30, 120. Now, this is the result which I am getting from Lami's theorem. I can use this equation to calculate RP and RQ. So first we'll go for RP. I can write down, since Rp is equal to, it is W into sine 140. Divided by sine 100 that's equal to W is 1000 given in the problem sine 140 degree divided by sine 100 degree. So therefore, if I calculate reaction at P, my answer comes out to be 652.7 Newton. My first answer. I can write similarly RQ will be equal to RQ will be W into sine 120 or you can take RP into sine 120 anything but you will get the same answer. So if I take W into sine 120 and divide it by sine 100 degree, weight is 1000, so 1000 into sine 120 degree divided by sine 100 degree. So if I calculate all terms here carefully, numerator divided by denominator, my answer is 879.39 Newton for reaction at Q. That's my second answer. So, if you look at this question, there were two things asked to calculate Rp reaction at P, which is the plane inclined at 60 degree. That reaction was 652.7 Newton. Next, we were required to calculate reaction at Q, that is point Q, and the value was 879.39 Newton. So, both the reactions have been solved and we can easily say that question 4 is completed.